Moving on now, and an Albanian paedophile convicted of raping a 15-year-old schoolgirl has said he's happy he cannot be deported from the UK as his home country has lots of bad people there.
Oh, I've got to say that. Have we done no one can say his name, but it's G-J-I-N-G-J-E-R-G-J-I.
It's the noise that the French border police make when they see people coming across the channel to the UK. They just go... That's all that it is when they try and...
Yes. Anyway, tell us about
Zhijinzhiji, if that's how you say it. First arrived in the UK in 2000 after falsely claiming he was fleeing from war-torn Kosovo. Now, an immigration tribunal has ruled it would be unfair to strip him of his British citizenship. How ludicrous. Joining us now is Alan Mendoza, who is the founder of the Henry Jackson Society. Alan, great to have you back on the show. Every single time I open the newspaper, it seems to me some ne'er-do-well from another country has raped a kid and then said, please don't deport me, I'll be in trouble at home if you do. And the judges go, yeah, go on then, you can stay. What's going on?
Well, this case is even worse than that, because it started off, you mentioned he had claimed he had come from Kosovo, but he previously had tried to get in on his Albanian citizenship. That was rejected. He got sent back to Germany because there was a fingerprint analysis that went wrong. They somehow let him in without checking the previous attempts. His wife was let in and said, no, no, he's Albanian, not Kosovo. No one picked it up. Then he commits his paedophilia crime. And now, of course, it's being claimed he can't be deported because we made the mistake, not him, even though he lied. And as a result, it'd be cruel and unusual to remove him, which just tells you how mad the system actually is.
And these people, they usually say, if I go back to my home country, I'll be persecuted, because in my home country, they don't like paedophiles. They don't like rapists. I always want to say to them, well, actually, right here in Great Britain, we're not that keen on them either. And the way that this immigration tribunal has accepted his plea that I'll be persecuted if I go back to Albania is ridiculous. I mean, I don't care if he's persecuted if he goes back to Albania. And one of the reasons that the Albanians don't want him back is he'll be a threat to children, he'll be a threat to women. He's a paedophile rapist. So we have decided better to keep him here and have him be a threat to our women, to our children, than Albanian children. What is that all about?
Yeah, totally inexplicable again. As I said earlier, I think it's interesting, although he made the argument there are bad people in Albania, etc., the newspaper story quoted him as saying he's going to pop over there for a holiday soon, as soon as he gets his passport back. So it can't be that bad a place. No, I do think the reason he wasn't deported was less to do with that and more to do with the fact that somehow the Home Office making a mistake 20 years ago means it can't be rectified now. Now, I don't know anything else where a mistake happens and you suddenly go, oh, well, fine, then you made the mistake. Keep on doing whatever you want to do in this country. We're perfectly going to accept you. Clearly, there's a suggestion here that, you know, that he cannot stay. There ought to be some way of removing him, even if there was a mistake 20 years ago, simply because he has proven himself to be somebody who is not fit for British citizenship or staying in this country. So, come on, the programme really has to change. That whole system needs a radical overhaul and quickly, because so many cases like this keep on cropping up.
Can I just ask you an emotive question? What do you make of this? This is what he says, this, our friend, how do you say it? Zhiji says this. I'm all right. I've got no worries here. I came to the UK because I wanted a better life and I've found it. I like it here. It's unbelievable, isn't it?
Well, I mean, I'm sure he does, is my comment in response to that. That doesn't really matter in this case. I mean, I think, again, we really must stop allowing convicted criminals to have their sort of say on things like this as if it's somehow a valid piece of evidence that because they want to stay and they like their life here, that they should do. The reality is he tricked his way in. He then committed a crime. He should have been out. You know, he shouldn't have been in the first place, and he should certainly have been out after his criminality was exposed and he served his sentence. Instead, we've ended up with him doing all those things and apparently being allowed to stay in perpetuity. If that doesn't demonstrate a broken system, I don't know what does.